So, what's the craziest thing?
This is such a stupid question.
I went out with two girls on the same night. And they found out.
They found out. You know, Sabi, you know, Sabi.
No, it was bad luck, man. It was,
you know, plan now. Where? No, you go, don't
see, I plan now.
Ferry is trying so hard to bring out the freaking in this housemate on different occasions. I've been noticing it. I've been seeing these things that he has been doing. We're going to talk about that in this video. We're going to talk about what happened last night and several other interesting things. If you want to see all of that, keep watching and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Turn on your post notifications so that I can get notified each time I post a brand new video. And don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. So yesterday Perry asked the housemates a question, like, what's the most freaky thing that they've done before? And he asked, like, they were sitting on the table, like, different housemates, himself, Saga, Yusef, Princess, Sasuke, they were just there. And then different people that were coming to the table, they would just ask them. The people that said something that I heard were Perry, Yusef, Maria, White Money. Sasuke didn't really say much. So as for Perry, I think Perry's one, like, was the freakiest. He said that the freakiest thing he has done was to receive BJ when he was driving at 80 miles per hour.
I was driving about 80 miles per hour and having my dick sucked so far.
80 freaking miles. So you're driving at 80 freaking miles and you're getting freaky in the car. Like, that's crazy. It's not just freaky, it is freaky, it is dangerous, it is. And I'm very sure this thing probably have been happening in the night. Why would you do that? I don't know why people will be risking their lives like that. I've heard of situations where people got really like, people got into an accident because of that. So his housemates now went further to ask him whether he came. So, like, nah, he did not, because of, like, the situation on ground. Then Sasuke said that she hasn't really done a lot of all this and she hasn't really been into, like, different things that she is. So they were asking her, are you a virgin, this and that and that. She now said no, that she's celibate and she has been celibate for 7 months and counting. So, and that she hasn't really had all these experiences that they are talking about.
I'm 7 months and it's not even a joke. I'm very serious. Anyways, well, I don't have all these experiences.
How old are you?
I'm 21.
Oh, okay.
Then Yusef said that the freakiest thing he has done is to be with two girls. He went clubbing with two girls at the same time. And I'm like, hey, Yusef, wow. We didn't know all these things, so. Then they asked Maria and she was like, don't you guys understand that I'm a private person? You know, that's what she was saying. You understand that I'm a private person? I'm like, oh, okay, oh, wow. So after she said she's a private person, they were still, like, trying to move her to talk. They were like, and you know, what's there? She was not like, and she has done everything. So, you know, what are they really asking about? That she's done everything.
Why would you guys ask me that?
So make of it what you wish. Then White Money said that for him, it was him massaging his balls, which he has said before. He has talked about it before, that that's what he does. That's what he does. I can't remember the way they asked the question before, but that's what White Money said, that he usually massages his balls, that he heard that it helps to prevent cancer. I'm like, okay. But he said he has been trying to prevent doing that in the house before. He would train for that kind of thing, that when he wants to do it, he would just use his body. He just uses his body and just adjust a little bit so that he would just massage it, but he has not really used his hand to massage it, divided that. If he wants to do this, to massage, divide, you know, you jingle it a little bit. I'm like, oh my god, what are these guys saying?
Oh my god, I didn't see you. I don't be like this. You better not be like this. That couple now, they do. When I come outside, they just use me do meme. Give me the one emoji.
So I can't think any other person said anything. Or they asked Liquor Rose and she was trying to think, she didn't remember. And then Perry was like, ah, these people are shy, you guys are shy. And she was just like, ah, she can't really remember, that she's trying to think. And I was like, Perry, this Perry, it's last set that he feeds. It's not this set. Because the last set of housemates, by this time, they've already revealed everything, their deepest secrets, everything. Even in their, it was even in their introduction, gone, that they talked about like things that they do in secret and stuff. In fact, that's how the last housemate, they were just revealing so much. When it comes to like sexual conversations, they were just very, very open. You're the one, you that's listening to it, you're the one that will just be like, ah, please don't say too much. Yeah, you're the one that will be shy on their behalf. That's how last year's set was. It's as if this year, when they were interviewing them, they asked them, do you know how to talk dirty? And if you say yes, they'll say, no, you can't go in. Because these ones are much more careful, not only in like the whole freaky talk, generally they are much more careful. When they have like an argument, it doesn't even last. Before you even say, let you pick up the argument, the next thing they are reconciling, they're like, ah, which kind of maturity is this one? So then, you know, in so many other ways, even with the whole bonding relationship thing, everybody is like being careful, which I think is okay. That's actually the natural thing to do. Like, you have to take it slow. That's the way it is normally. Everything just doesn't just happen at once. It's with time that things will just build up and like, you know, go get into something serious. Then, have you watched Yusef in the morning doing his dance steps? Hey God. Yusef is a comedian and he doesn't even know. Sometimes I like to watch their exercise just to see Yusef dancing. If you see Yusef dancing, it's just like when Mike was trying to learn how to sing in the dance in his own season. That's how Yusef looks when he's dancing. It's always so funny. And the worst part is that he's serious. Like, he's always serious trying to learn how to do the different dance steps. And for some reason, I don't know why he looks funny trying to dance. So that's like my comedy scene in the morning. If I'm able to meet up with the exercise, that's usually my comedy scene in the morning. Then Liqua Rose has hit 1 million followers on Instagram. So she's presently the most followed housemate in this season, although she went in with she had a large following before she even got in. I think about 600 and something thousand or around 700 and something thousand followers. So she has gained over 300,000 plus followers just on entering the house. So even if she even leaves now, she's like, she has really, really done well. She's already like a household name to a lot of people. So see, somehow, Shad, first week really, really matters. You need to make yourself known. Then they showed a scene where she was crying and talking about something that she did for her dad, that the money that they gave them while they were staying in the hotel, apparently they usually give them money when they go into the hotel, and she sent it to her dad that all she cared about that time was whether her dad was eating and stuff. So I don't know if it's this time around or the previous set, because I know the previous set she was going to go into the house and she didn't make it again. I think she was there with them at the hotel, but she didn't make it. I don't know if she's talking about the previous set or this set, but I shall know that she said she sent the money to her dad because she was concerned about his well-being and stuff. So she was just crying, being emotional. But I think the conversation did not start from her. They were talking to Sammy, because the way they were all surrounding him, like they were trying to ginger him to like gain his confidence back, that he deserves to be here and everything. You know, Sammy has been all about like, you know, based on where I came from, where I come from. But the English is not coming. I don't feel like I deserve to be here. You get like looking at all the people that are here. So I think yesterday they were also trying to like give him some form of confidence and everything. I'm like, Sammy, I don't trust it. So Liqua Rose was not giving her own story, and that's when she was now like crying. I think she was giving her story as a form of like confidence booster, that, you know, things happen. Not everybody is coming from where you think they are coming from. People go through a lot of things. So that's why she was giving her own story. Then Nini, they've already started campaigning for Nini in Edo State, I'll be where. And I'm like, hey, she has never started. If I already started doing campaign, I guess maybe it's people that she already has outside, or people, her own people that are just like putting out there for you guys to see, okay, oh, this person is on the show, you know, go and vote for her. I mean, have her as part of the people that you like to vote for. So, but they are campaigning for her already. Then there's something that I want to talk about with you guys, just like a brief comment on something that I was moved to talk about this morning in my video this morning, because I saw it this morning. So I saw a post by Ubi Franklin, and it directed me to another person's page, Antlanda. I don't know if you guys know Antlanda on Instagram. So basically what she does is she helps people that are oppressed by their people that they're living with. Even if it's your child, like let's say you're abused, let me use the word abuse, people that are being abused by the people that are staying with, she goes to help them, especially like children and stuff. So this morning I saw a post where she went to help a boy that was being abused for four whole months by one lady that he's staying with. Even the lady and her children were abusing the boy. They used to hit his head on the wall, he eats from dustbin, he sleeps outside. Like, do you know what it means by when someone is like really, really maltreated? So they went to rescue the boy and they took the lady to prison and stuff. So I just went to her page and yeah, I saw a lot of other things that she had been doing. I even noticed that I was following her. I think I've seen her post before. And I was really, really, really touched. Like, this is what humanity is about, to be honest. This is what I feel humanity is about. Like, being able to really help those that need that help. A lot of people are in this situation and nobody's really doing anything about it. But somebody has been able to dedicate themselves to like doing something like this. I applaud her so much. So I said, let me share it with you guys so you guys can like check her Instagram page. Then those that want to, you know, support can also support. So I'm just bringing awareness to this kind of thing. And if you have anybody that is being oppressed around your area, you can reach out to them, you can call out to them, and they can come with like, you know, the authorities or police force to rescue them. So yeah, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching and don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. Her Instagram handle is going to be in the description box and I'm going to see you guys in my next video. Bye, love you.